Hi everyone, Pete Calamain here. I hope you're having an awesome day. So in today's video, I would like to show you how you can design your schematic and PCB footprints in Altium. So there's a couple of ways to do that. I'll skip the first two points, but basically you can do it manually or you can do it semi-automatic. Manually, the question is, why would you even consider this? Well, in some cases, there's just no availability of a specific footprint for a specific IC that you want to use. If they are available, then of course you can look into semi-automatic generation with tools like SnapEDA, the manufactured parts search in Altium, or vendor-specific libraries. But today, very specifically, I want to show you, if these not exist, how can you do it manually? So I'm going to show you an example with the BME 680 sensor from Bosch. Let's dive into it. And we'll go to the datasheet there. And I'm interested in the mechanical specs. Let's see if where we can find them. So landing pattern recommendation, this is what you are looking for. And normally in every data sheet, this is provided. So there's a landing pattern that the supplier of the chip recommends. So if you're doing SMD soldering, they are recommending this. And there's a landing pattern, and then there's a solder stop, what you could use in this case. So there's a landing pattern of 0.4. And then there is some extra definition here in case a solder mask is used, no solder mask is used, what dimension you should use. So in our case, we will assume that we make the pads 0.6 by 0.6. So how can we do that? I would start first of all making a component. And for that, I typically make it a bit easier. I use an existing component, so you, for instance, you could use this one. There we go. And then I will start by adding the pins. So pin one. Pinout is not provided here, was a bit higher if I remember well. Yeah, pin one is ground. Then we have pin two, that is CSB. Then pin 3, there is SDI. Pin 4, SCK. Pin 5 is called SDO. Then we have pin 6, that's VDD-IO. Then 7 is ground, 8 is VDD. Okay, done. So you have your schematic component. What you need to do here is to add a footprint still, but of course we have not created the footprint yet. So let's go ahead and do that. Save this one. In Altium, you have your schematic library. So we are still in the project view here, but if you click schematic library, normally you should get an overview of what is in that library. So in our Centineo schematic library that you just made, it is called component one. So let's call it BME 680. You can add a designator. So typically you would do it like that, and then it will automatically increase in your schematic. So that's that. We have our schematic footprint for the BME 680. Then we will make a PCB footprint there. Interesting thing is here to use a wizard. So I will use the IPC compliant footprint wizard to get a start there. And let's go with QFN, and then we will alter it a bit. So if you have a QFN and there is no package provided, these values E, D, and so on, this will be provided in your datasheet. So right here, I will make an estimation based on these dimensions. But if you're using a chipset that is a QFN, typically you will see this E, D dimension, A, A1, and so on. And you can just take it over here in the footprint wizard. So the body range, 3 mm by 3, let's say. I'll just use it the same. Height around 1 mm, let's say that's okay. I will show you in a bit how I will alter that. Lead width will be around 0.4, let's say 0.3. Then the pitch in between, there is 0.8 pitch. Thermal pad range, there is none. The important one is the number of pins. It's 4 on each side. 0 here. So that's already a bit more resembling to what I want to have. Again, this is a quick way to get started. And you'll see in a bit how I will change it. So I'm using rectangular. The path dimensions x1, y1, I would like to have it at 0.4 millimeters. Then x2 and y2, that's the thermal pad. We will delete that in a bit. But then the pad spacing is an important one as well. So if I can find that here, yes, the pad spacing is 2.4 millimeters. C1, I'm not sure if C2 is the correct one. Let's put it for both. Good. Then BME 680 gas sensor. Next. Then yeah, you can add it in your current PCB lip. Done. So what we have here is of course not complete, and this pad needs to go. Then let's see if the, first of all, so via the top view, we can already see that there is something wrong because yeah, we are assuming QFN, but it's not a real QFN. So if you have the top view, this is as well a top view. Pin 1 would be here and pin 8 on the other side. So 8, 6. This is 8. Via the properties, we make that pin 8. Let's see if I can bring up the properties here, that would make it a bit quicker. Yes, there we are. So we make that 7. Six. You get the idea. Four, is that the correct? Four, yes. Okay, so now they have the correct numbering. Then the next step is to make sure that we are doing the things according to the landing pattern. So there's 3 mm over here. We knew that in between it was 2.4 to use. So let's verify that. The X is minus 1.2. This one is at 1.2, so there's 2.4 in between. That's already exactly what we need, and then we need to verify the 0.8. If you look at the coordinates, 0.4, so this should be at 1.2, yes. So this is exactly what we need. And then there's a 3D body assigned to that as well. In this case, the BME has another form. It's not really this flat. It's more, you could see it on top here. It's more like this, but yeah, this works of course well enough. If you really want to have the exact type of body, you can look it up, see if there is a step module available for that, and then put it in here. So that's a quick walkthrough how to make a manual model. Of course, there's a lot of things that can be discussed here, but this is something that maybe is too specific then for this software package. This is just to give you a quick idea how I would make a manual footprint. And you see that we had to already swap around a bit the pinout. We had to go into the datasheet. We know the dimensions and so on, the possibilities for reflow. So it's much more than just adding an automatic component or adding it automatically. So I'm really in favor of doing this manually. It took me 5 or maybe 10 minutes, but this is now a component that I'm sure of that will be okay if I put it in the design. And also if I reuse it, there's of course no time involved anymore to do it. It has already been tested. Important one here then would also be to put the dot for number one at the real number one pin. So that's it. So I hope this video was useful for you. If you have any questions, of course feel free to add them in the comments below. If you got some value out of this video, please give the video a like, and feel free to subscribe. That would mean a lot to me. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.